Welcome student, to our today's section of subject power engineering refrigeration, and today we are going to take another concept. So let's start us from this fuels which we are going to use in this IC engine. So there are two types of fluids. First one can be stated as liquid fuel, another can be stated as the gaseous fluid. These fluids which we are going to use inside the internal combustion engine here, okay. So the liquid fluids having classified into two again. First one is the natural fuels and other one is the artificial fuels. The natural fuels are of course example is petroleum, and for the artificial fuels they are the petroleum based fuels, example gasoline, kerosene, diesel and fuels. This gasoline, kerosene, they are derived from this petrol products, or they can be stated as the petroleum products because they derived artificially from the original one. And again we are having this non-petroleum based, example is benzol, alcohols and acetone. These are the artificially created by the humans. Then here the gaseous fuels again classified into two. First one is the natural fuel and other one is the artificial fluids. In natural fluids, natural gas, it is example of this natural gaseous fuel, and artificial fuels are LPG, which is liquid petroleum gas. But it is better to call it as a liquefied petroleum gas because this gas is kept in the liquid state under high pressure. Again, this CNG, you all are familiar with the CNG. It is used currently. It is also called as the green gas because the pollution created by CNG is very low. So this CNG, then this producer gases, then coal gas or hydrogen, all these gases comes under the artificial gases fuels. Okay students, so in exam you may have the question such as state any 8 names of fuel used in the IC engine and write any 4 properties of petrol. So at that time you need to mention the fluid which we are going to study today. So here are some names of these fuels: diesel, petrol and compressed natural gas, which is CNG, then LPG, liquefied petrol gas, then alcohol and benzene. All these are the fuels which we are going can be used in the IC engine. Then now the properties of petrol. First property is the volatility. At various operating temperature, fuel must have sufficient volatility. So this is the important property of this petrol, it should be volatile. Then again this viscosity, it is the property at lower operating temperature fuel must be flow through the fuel system. So viscosity, it is the property of fluid by which the fluid can flow, or by which one layer of fluid flows over another layer, and this property of this fluid should be maintained. This is the property of petrol, so that at low temperature it is remains in its liquid form. Then corrosion. The fuel should not cause corrosion. Corrosion means rusting. Rusting should not, the fuel should not produce the rusting. You know that use of petrol is used to avoid corrosion. Then knocking property. Ability to knock depends upon their chemical composition. You know that knocking or detonation, these are the some defects caused inside the IC engine. But less knocking property is defined, and it depends on their chemical composition of this fluid. Then lubrication, additives and their advantages. So here you can read. During working of engine, the lubricants are affected by several conditions such as temperature, that necessitates that the lubricant remain in fluid state even at high temperature. Because of this, degradation of the lubricants occurs at cause damage to the metal surfaces by wear and tear. Normally what happens, the degradation of the lubrication causes damage to the metal surface by wear and corrosion. So proper lubrication increases the lifespan of engine and reduces the maintenance. You know that we are always providing the lubrications to the various parts which comes under the mechanical work, for example sliding, etc. All these parts requires the lubrication here. And if you provide sufficient lubrication, that it increases the lifespan of this engine and also reduces the maintenance. Hence, the improved property by addition of the chemical compounds called additives. So, to improve the property of this fluid, some additives are used there. Now, this is the main purpose of lubricant additives. So, we are providing these additives to improve the life of the IC engine and to reduce the maintenance. So, first one is the lubricant protection. These are the additives which we provide with the lubrication. The lubricant protection, inhibition of thermo-oxidative degradation, antioxidant inhibition of catalytic effects on the of the metal surface, metal deactivators and corrosion inhibitors. So main purpose of lubrication additives is lubricant protection. Your lubricant oil should be protected, otherwise it will get contaminated, and if it gets contaminated, then it will not perform its function systematically. That's why lubricant protection is required. And how we are going to achieve this lubricant protection? By adding some additives in it. Then metal surface protection, the metal surface of the cylinder should be protected, and for this purpose, we should add some additives. Then flow protection. To decrease the temperature at which non-synthetic lubricants start to solidify, pour point depression to help lubricant function at this low temperature, supporting continued equipment operation, example, so that viscosity modified. Flow protection means if the temperature of this decreases, temperature goes beyond the limit, so at this temperature, flow should be protected. So flow protection is provided by adding some additives there. Then here we are having some main additives example. First one is the detergent, dispersant, then antioxidant or anti-corrosives, then pour point depressors, then anti-foam agents, then rust inhibitors, then viscosity index improvers, then oiliness and film strength agents. Here we are going to study one by one. The first one is the detergent and dispersant. The additive improves the detergent action of the lubrication oil by keeping the deposit in the suspension form. In this, additives are oil soluble. Normally the the additives improve the detergent action means what? The impurities present inside the get dispersant inside this lubrication oil, and it will not causes the problem to the lubrication oil. And examples are metallic salt and organic acids. Then next is the antioxidant and anti-corrosiveness. So at high temperature, oxidation of lubrication oil increases. The oxidation also increases by presence of certain metals such as copper, which act as a catalyst for oxidation. Oxidation means here oxygen reacts with the hydraulic oil and which reduces the functional ability of the oil. So oxidation is undesirable because of the sludge and varnish are created. Acid also forms which are corrosive. So to eliminate this oxidation, we are going to use the antioxidant as an additive with the lubrication oil. Antioxidant means they eliminate the process of or slow down the process of oxidation. This additive used to decrease the oxidation and corrosiveness characteristics of the lubrication oil. These additives are in the form of the sulfur and phosphorus compound or amine or and phenyl derivatives. Zinc here zinc Thiophosphate, used as an antioxidant and anti-corrosive additive. These antioxidant and anti-corrosive agents are slow down the process of oxidation and which prevents the oil, and the function of the lubrication oil is maintained there. Okay, then it's a 4-point depressor. Here, lubricant contains paraffin compounds and form wax precipitates as they cool. Wax reduces the fluidity of oil at low temperature. Pore depressants are added to lower the pore point of the lubricating oil. If the oil reaches to this pore point, then it will cause the creation of the wax on the wall of the cylinder. To eliminate this, we are going to use the pore point depressor. Pore point depressor means the lowers the pore point. The example of this pore point depressant are polymerized phenols, then esters, then alkylates, naphthalene and air methacrylate polymers. All these are the pore point depressor. Then anti-foam agents. These are the additives with the lubrication oil. The additive prevents the formation of the foam by reducing the surface tension, which allows air bubble to separate from oil more rapidly. If the foam is get formed, then there are some disadvantages of this foam. And to eliminate this foam, we are going to use the anti-foam agent. And the example for anti-foam agent can be written as the silicon polymers. Then rust inhibitors is the another additive. This rust inhibitor, it prevents the rusting of ferrous engine parts during the storage and form acidic moisture accumulation during the cold engine operation. Example of these rust inhibitors are bitter sulfonate, fatty acid and amines. Then viscosity index improvers. They increase the viscosity index so that at low temperature also the viscosity of oil remains high there. Then oiliness and film strength agent. Oiliness and high film strength are important parameters for partial film lubrication. These additives like sulfur, phosphorus and chlorine are used to improve the film strength of lubricants here. Then again, the same information is present on this page also that these are the additives and these are their applications or these are their functions. Why you are going to use this particular additives with the lubricating oil there. Then now we are going to study the pollutants inside the exhaust gas. First pollutant is here, hydrocarbons. Hydrocarbon can be denoted by capital H and capital C. Hydrocarbon in SI engine. The hydrocarbon are formed by incomplete combustion of the fuel and complete misfire occurs when combustion quality is poor. Hydrocarbons occurs in the exhaust gas when there is a incomplete combustion of the fuel gases takes place. The major cause of unburnt hydrocarbon in the exhaust is the quenching of the flame as it approaches a relative cool metal surfaces. The quantity of unburnt hydrocarbon depends upon the turbulence and combustion chamber design. Here the turbulence means this. Turbulence means here what happens, the turbulence and the design of this combustion chamber can causes the unburnt gases or unburnt charge inside this cylinder. Since flame does not reach at end of the trailing chamber, as a layer of rich unburnt hydrocarbon is formed on the wall. Here this unburnt hydrocarbon get formed on the wall, that's why which causes its elimination, and this hydrocarbon get emitted from this IC engine. Here you can see this hydrocarbons in combustion ignition engine. The combustion ignition engine operates with an overall fuel burn equivalent ratio. Therefore, they emits 1/5 of this hydrocarbon compared with SI engine. This major cause of this hydrocarbon emission in CI engine are the diesel fuel compound contains higher molecular weight on average than the SI engine fuels, resulting in higher boiling and condensing temperature. Then the hydrocarbon particles condense on the surface of the solid carbon soot generated during the combustion. Here in case of the compression ignition engine, more halocarbons are produces instead of this spark ignition engine. The next reason is air fuel mixture is heterogeneous. It causes local spot of rich and lean mixture. The fuel rich mixture do not find oxygen to reach find oxygen to react, causes its incomplete combustion. Here what is happened, this when this fuel is get during this compression ignition engine, when this fuel is spread on these gases, then it is not spread homogeneously, it is spread heterogeneously. That's why where the high air fuel ratio, where the high fuel is present, it does not get sufficient oxygen to burn, and this at that places the fuel gases may remains unburned, and these unburned gases can move out of the engine, and which are the mostly the hydrocarbon. Again, a small amount of liquid fuel is trapped at the tip of the injector nozzle, which fuel injection stop. The small volume of fuel called sac volume. This sac volume surrounded by fuel rich environment, and it evaporates slowly, causes hydrocarbon emission in the exhaust gas here. Again, as they are telling us that the injection nozzle of this injector, so there will be the formation of the sac volume, and this sac volume evaporates slowly, causes the hydrocarbon to emit there. Okay. Then another pollutant is the carbon monoxide, which is generated by CO. Carbon monoxide are formed as a result of cold flame reaction and rich fuel ratios in combustion chamber with local deficiency of oxygen, which causes incomplete combustion, creates carbon monoxide. Normally what happens, CO2, and this is the CO. Here the oxygen is provided in less quantity, that's why it's having only one molecule. So carbon monoxide causes by the local deficiency of oxygen. Here the SI engine operates close to the stoichiometric ratio of the fuel as a part load and operates rich as a fuel load. Under this condition, the CO emission are significant, where compression ignition operated well at lean stoichiometric ratio and produces less CO in the emission. Here the carbon monoxide creation is more in case of the spark ignition engine and less in case of the compression ignition engine. Again, you are having this another pollutant, which is nitrogen oxide, NOx. The oxide of nitrogen are formed within the combustion chamber due to the dissociation of molecular oxygen and nitrogen at peak combustion temperature and persist during the expansion and exhaust stroke. The amount of NOx depend on the concentration of atomic oxygen and nitrogen and also temperature. You know that air contains nitrogen. So at high temperature, this oxygen and nitrogen can dissociate and will produce the nitrogen oxide, which is represented by NOx. Here NOx or NO2 can be taken. The high temperature, what is the reason of this? This is the high temperature, at high temperature dissociation of oxygen and nitrogen takes place. Here you can see this activities. Here this NO2 plus energy from sunlight, it produces NO plus O plus smog. Then this O plus O2 gives O3 as a ozone. Then this N2 reacts with the oxygen, produces the NO plus N. Then again here the here that ozone depletion also they are showing here, that how this nitrogen and oxygen react with each other. It is not much more important. Much more important is that you just have to remember that nitrogen dioxide, it is the another pollutant present in the exhaust gas of the IC engine here. No one is going to ask for this chemical reaction here. Then here we are having this particulates. In SI engine, particulates are lead, organic particulates including soot and the sulfates. The fuel contains sulfur, which oxidizes within the engine cylinder from SO2. The SO2 is oxidized with the SO, oxidized to SO. So 3 here. Then it combines with the water from sulfuric acid and aerosol. Leading fuel emits lead components, soot emission, black smoke is result of rich mixture. Then in CI engine, carbonaceous material, which some organic compounds have been absorbed, most of the particulates generate due to the incomplete combustion of the fuel here. Now in the next lecture, we will see about the effect of pollutant on the environment in the next section. Thank you. If you have any doubt, then you can contact me on my WhatsApp number.